Just how dangerous is it to look directly at the eclipse? If you're not in the path of totality, will you even see anything? A total solar eclipse doesn't come around every day. The next one won't be seen in the U.S. until 2044, so you don't want to mess this up. You've got questions, we've got answers, or at least my next guests do. And joining us now, co-host of Today, Al Roker, and the one and only Bill Nye, the science guy, a science educator, and CEO of the Planetary Society. Oh, so good to have both of you here with us today. Al, it's a treat because I know it's a long day for you after you started so early. How are the preparations going where you are there in Dallas as the anticipation's just building and building?
Well, Anna, we're at the Perot Museum of Nature and Science. Huge event here. They're expecting about 7,000 people. We've got bands who are going to be playing. We've got all sorts of events. There are going to be a lot of kids here. We've had them since this morning. The city of Dallas is probably the biggest city that will be experiencing the path of totality, 1.5 million people. They expect almost a half million people to come downtown. This could generate almost a half a billion dollars in revenue. Hotels, 99% sold out. So this is pretty amazing. Our eclipse begins right around 12:23 Central Time. And I'm really excited about it. We've got clouds right now. But it's expected to clear off. Fingers crossed, we may have some high clouds, but all in all, we're expecting some good news. And again, I'm looking forward to seeing this because the next one isn't until 2044. At that point, I'm going to be on a Smucker's jar. So I'm really looking forward to this.
Al, you're timeless. You are timeless. Never going to be on that Smucker's jar. We always think of you as immortal. Thank you for checking in with us, and we know you'll be there to capture it all as it goes throughout the day. So, Bill, let me ask you, because you have said this is an event that will change our lives. How so?
Well, it gives you something to think about. That is to say, your place in space, your relationship to the cosmos. And it is a remarkable event. Even if you're not in totality, it's still remarkable. You get a partial solar eclipse. It's still spectacular. I heard you start this, Anna, with it's dangerous to look at the eclipse. It's dangerous to look at the eclipse without proper eyewear. So these glasses are available all over the place, even though they're made of cardboard and very thin mylar plastic. They are completely effective for looking at the sun. You can look at it all day, as long as you want. And the trouble is, we've all glanced at the sun. You know, I say all the time, you ever played the outfield in softball? You look at the sun for a moment. The trouble is, when there's an eclipse, you just want to stare at it. Mm-hmm. And Al, the sun is coming out here. We're in Fredericksburg, Texas, which is just a couple hours drive from Dallas. We're right in the middle of the path. I'm very excited about that. And everybody, if you have an electric mobile phone that a lot of the kids use, you know how bright the flashlight is. If you hold the light up to these glasses, you can't see anything. They're about 100,000 times darker than conventional sunglasses. So we encourage everybody to wear the glasses and take it all in. The other thing I'll just say to everybody, speaking of mobile phones, everybody takes pictures. There are billions of pictures taken every day around the world, in North America, billions of pictures. But just take those few moments and be in it. Be present. And look at the sky with your glasses on, and then look around and enjoy it with the people you're with. It's the so-called shared experience. The same reason we go to theaters.
Yes.
And it is just a remarkable thing in the cosmos that our satellite, the moon, blocks the same width of sky as the sun. It doesn't happen anywhere else in the solar system. It probably doesn't happen very many places in the galaxy. So let's enjoy it, you all.
You are right. This is so super cool. I'm glad you showed us the experiment with the flashlight with these glasses, because when I put them on, you're right, you can't see a thing, but you don't want people to take them off.
You're looking at the sun.
Yeah, your sunglasses, you can see out of. These you can't until you look at the sun, and that is an important distinction. Let's talk more about what happens with an eclipse, Bill, because I think, you know, there's so much curiosity. We haven't experienced it. A lot of us, this is the first time we'll have experienced it. Will it get colder? Will animals act all funny? What are some things we should be watching for specifically?
So a couple things. Yes, the animals, at least in my experience, act as though it's nighttime. Crickets start cricketing, birds start chirping. And indeed, often, when the ground gets cool, locally, right where you're standing watching the thing, the air gets cool, and then it squeezes the warm air up on either side of the path, and you get a gentle breeze for those few minutes. It's remarkable. The other thing, encourage everybody, make your own observations. If I may, don't come running to me. Notice for yourself what happens during a total solar eclipse. And as my old professor Carl Sagan used to say, if you were a psychic or a tarot card reader or something, and you could make any kind of prediction, anything like what astronomers can do with total solar eclipses, well, you'd be in pretty good business. But those people in that those businesses can't. No, this is a remarkable thing that is it's attributed to our understanding of the cosmos and our place within it. It is attributed to what, Anna?
Well,
science. That's right.
Science.
It's all science. That's right. Just as it says, Article 1, Section 8, Clause 8 of the U.S. Constitution. This is part of promoting the progress of science. Well, so thanks for having me on, you all, and enjoy the eclipse.
I love seeing you in your element. Bill Nye, thank you for sharing your enthusiasm and understanding of science with all of us and just being part of this special day here in the U.S. You're ready? I'm ready.
I'm ready.
We are ready. All right. I got to take these off so I can read the teleprompter. Thank you, Bill. Have a great rest of the day. And may the eclipse forces be with you.
Hey, everyone. MSNBC has a new and improved app. You'll get real-time alerts and analysis, live blogs, in-depth essays, video highlights, and the best 2024 election coverage. Download the new MSNBC app. Here's how to do it. You tap on the App Store on your phone. You hit search on the bottom right corner. You type in MSNBC. You click on the MSNBC app. You click on get or the cloud icon and enjoy it.